Well, this is new at 4. A University of Idaho professor is part of a team studying the tuskless elephant phenomenon in a region of Africa. Now, they just published research that shows elephants there are evolving without tusks very quickly. Take a look at some video. This is from Dr. Ryan Long shooting an elephant with a tranquilizer dart from a helicopter flying over the Gorongosa National Park in Mozambique. Just a few minutes after the darting, the elephant lies down sedated. Dr. Long and his team quickly land, gather their gear, and rush over to the elephant to take blood samples. Now, they've collected blood samples from a total of 18 elephants, 7 with tusks and 11 without. Long and his colleagues at Princeton University, Elephant Voices, and Gorongosa National Park just published a paper in Science on what their research has found. Now, they discovered the female elephants are quickly evolving without tusks, partly because of a black market poaching during the Civil War in Mozambique that lasted from 1977 to 1992. They also found genetic evidence of the impact this tuskless trait is having on the population. And our Doug Petcash talked with Dr. Long for this Sunday's Viewpoint. Take a listen.
Were tuskless elephants more likely to survive the poaching because they didn't have tusks, so the poachers weren't as interested?
Yeah, that's exactly right. And that's what's led to the evolution of tusklessness in this population. So based on the results of our analyses during that period when the war was going on, females that lacked tusks had about 5 times higher probability of surviving than their tusked counterparts. And as a result, essentially tusks became a liability in that population as a result of the intense poaching pressure.
So this really kind of threw off the gene pool too, didn't it?
Yeah, it had a big effect on the gene pool. This mutation on the X chromosome that before had only occurred at very low frequencies in this population because there was really no benefit to it, suddenly increased in frequency substantially because it was the tuskless females that were surviving and then were able to pass that that mutation on to their offspring in the next generation. Is that we don't know, you know, what it is that causes male offspring to die in utero when they inherit this mutated X chromosome from their mother. Tuskless females are going to only be able to give birth to half of the male offspring that they conceive, right? So females have 2 X chromosomes, and tuskless females have 1 normal X chromosome and 1 X chromosome that has this mutation on it, right? So by chance, if they conceive a male, it has a 50-50 shot of getting either the normal X chromosome, and if it does, it'll be born and it'll develop tusks just like any other elephant. If it gets the mutant X chromosome, though, it'll die in utero.
Now, because of poaching during the Civil War, the elephant population dropped in the region from more than 2,500 to around 200. It's bounced back now to about 800, but the war drastically affected other animals as well. On Viewpoint, Dr. Long also describes the amazing animal comeback. Viewpoint airs Sunday morning at 9 o'clock on News Channel 7, right here after Meet the Press.